So first Moto coming up off Bud's Creek. So let's see here, spectating Nicky Jusic for the start. Looks like he's taking a careful turn through there. Looks like Kevin Lilong with the hole shot. Followed by Dennis Fjellberg, which with cloth I can't see. Third we have Matt Birkin, so our top contenders immediately up front. Always fun to see. So Birkin now on a Kawasaki. I think last time I saw his bike was a Honda, so cool there. See some bike changes. Going off the track, no worries. Oh, getting passed by Bledos Clement Lana. Still Kevin Lilong up front, so strong effort here of Kevin Lilong coming right out of the gate. I wonder which is superior, if you actually triple into the single layer in the inside. That's something I've been trying to figure out for quite some time, but I don't know, I don't have to race, so not a word for mine. Fjellberg is changing up the lines, going from inside to inside, or inside, outside, inside, perhaps. Looking pretty solid already, going to the inside, getting the drive, and getting up. Looks like Jeremy Seabolt don't want to be commenting with me or something. That's interesting. Oh, can't log into Twitch. So Fjellberg with a solid lead, way out of Kevin Lilong, followed by Clement Lana. No, Victor Nykvist at this point. Matt Birkin and then Clement Lana, so probably something that happened. Jonathan Olsson there as well, so pretty much everyone up front running Kawasaki's. Kind of boring, but nice to see as well. So nice to see Jonathan Olsson. I know he actually prefers the CRF 450, but he didn't have one on the dyno available, so I don't know which bike he actually runs at this point. I think it's the Kawasaki. Fjellberg still showing a way in the lead. Looks like there is a battle shaping up for second place. We have Kevin Lilong and Victor Nykvist. Looks like Nykvist is making up a little bit of time. Lilong crashing. So that allows Nykvist to go by. There goes Birkin. And Clement Lana is trying to go to the inside. And those are teammates, so you don't want to punt too much there. So Kevin Lilong falling back a few positions due to that crash. Seems like everyone is preferring the inside, except Birkin. And behind here we have Brandon Enink. Actually, first guy on a non-Kawasaki. So fun to see people riding different bikes, even though they probably ride the same dynos. But it's always good to see. Looks like we have Kevin Lilong down again. So Lilong not having the best of luck here at Bud's Creek. Already at lap 4? Wow. So, but it's still had about 25 minutes of racing to go, so no worries there. ...154, that's a pretty respectable lap time. So I wanna see here what Brandon Enink can do, going on board with him. trying to catch the number 60 of Clement Lana, as well as I believe that's Victor Nycott in front, going down, inning to the inside, making the pass stick. Oh, quite a lot of guys. Johnson also down there as well. So quite messy, but still pretty good racing. So pretty good training with Kawasaki guys, and up front we have Dennis Fjellberg, followed by Victor Nycott, Brandon Enink, Clement Lana, Matt Birkin, and Jonathan Olson. So 5 out of the top 6 is Kawasaki's at the moment, except for Fjellberg, but last minute so he was on a Kawasaki, so I assume it's pretty much the same. Yannick Muller, 12th place. Matthias Liedman, 16th. Seabolt, who should be commenting with me, who is not, is at 17th. And we also saw Clement Lana go down, so Lana is going to drop back a few positions. Looks like Kustetan is Fjellberg. Must have made a mistake in that case. Yeah, it is Fjellberg. Inink. Oh, Fjellberg way off the track. I don't know what he did, but that wasn't Fjellberg. Who was it? Guess we'll have to wait and see. Fjellberg still in lead. I have no idea who that guy was. But it looks to be a close battle. But Victor Nycott is slightly messing it up in the turn, already into lappers, so that was quick. Into lappers on lap 5, seem to be all over the place. And I hope, as we've seen in previous weeks, that lappers doesn't play too big of a role, because they've been kind of messy last few weeks. So Victor Nycott still in second, Matt Birkin in third, Jonathan Olsen in fourth, Anthony Bernard in fifth, Kevin Leelong, Eduardo Simos, Clement Lana. So seems like there's a lot of guys that caught up to the top 5 early in this race. Looks like Kevin Leelong getting squirrely, exiting the turn. Somebody just launching off of their rock of sleep. Brock Puppy doing that. Going to the inside. Almost clearing Clement Lana. But nothing to worry about. Nothing dirty. Yannick Muller sweat his way up to 9th place. Brandon Enick has dropped down to 12th. So weird to see guys dropping like that. I didn't expect that from Enink, but it could go either way. It's motorsport. But Seabird has made his way up the top 20. So Dennis Fjellberg. Not sure if he got punted or if he made a mistake. Somebody just being in his way. Just get around the 127th Nick Jusic, nicely staying out of any trouble. Leper seems really good right now. A lot of guys just taking precaution. Fjellberg trying to launch. But Nycott is about 14 seconds behind, so that shouldn't be too big of a problem to get going again. So Nycott, not too far behind, but still not in a striking distance. You can see that Matt Birkin is right on his tail, so battle for second is, I guess, soon to be expected. Oh, something happened with Burke, and I think he caught up with a lapper or something. He's down, allowing Jonathan Olson to pass by from Splitfire. I spoke to Jonathan pretty much right after the track was released, and he seemed to enjoy it, thinking that was a pretty decent track, one of the better Buds Creek. So, seems like a lot of people enjoy it, but a lot of people dislike it as well. I can't really think of any reason why you dislike, because it seems like a really nice track. Seems like we've got into a pile of flappers. Can't see any numbers really, but it's pretty much everyone. So Jonathan Olson really has to be cautious and not really force anything. Is that Dennis Fjellberg being down? I think so. Victor Nykott as well. Dennis Fjellberg, so Jonathan Olson is a new race leader. Our old EMF 250 2012 champion. So nice to see Jonathan back up in the lead. And I know that for sure that if he can just get up and get out front and stay focused, he can for sure win this thing. And he have had some control issues as well in the previous races, so he's finally bought a new Xbox controller, so he won't be disconnected in the middle of a race, because that's kind of sucky. So Fjellberg, not sure, being in second place. Nykott in third, Matt Birken in fourth, Anton Mara in fifth, Clement Lanne in sixth, Kevin Lilong in seventh, so Lilong worked his way back up, Sebastian Jost in eighth, Eduardo Simons ninth, Yannick Muller 10th, so Muller lost another spot. Brock Papp 11th, Brandon Enink 12th, so Enink lost it back up again. Cornette de la Rule, and so Botignity. Linus Goranson, Chase Danavant, Penn Seaborg, Durano Plevut, Rito Gasser, and Bronson Gasparian for the top 20. But Jonathan Olson looks to be on fire at the moment, leading the way of the first 250 Moto. Dennis Fjellberg still maintaining second place, not really making up any ground at all at this point. Victor Nykott third, Clement Lanne, now Matt Birken fourth, so close battle here for, oh, Birken going into the back of Nykott. Nykott trying to go to the inside, managed to do so. Looks like Anton Bernal was a lapper. So looks like Matt Birken still is third. Clement Lanne being fifth, Kevin Lilong sixth, so, and Anton Bernal seventh, so here's Bernal. Yannick Muller eighth, so Muller climbing back up again. Brock Papi in ninth, and Eduardo Simons in tenth. So it seems like to be battles all over the place, which is nice. It's just the worst to see a race without any battles at all. I believe that was the case with High Point last week for the 450s. Just nothing to spectate at all. So Eduardo Simons looking good on the bike. I really like the gear, the white and black. And we have 10 minutes to go plus 2 laps for the first 250 Moto. Looks like Lapper there, number something 25, staying out of the way. Nice. It looks like Brock Papp is trying to make the move on Yannick Muller. Looks like he did so as well. So Muller is probably going to try and come around and retake his position. So Brock Puppy seem to be on fire right now. It looks like Yannick Mulder is going to get passed again by Eduardo Simoes, but Yannick managing to stay out of being passed. Oh, Brock Puppy going. Nope. Yeah, Brock Puppy going down. As well as Eduardo Simoes. Trying to find any battles or something. Still looks like Jonathan also maintaining the lead of a few seconds before Dennis Fjellberg. So really good ride for Jonathan Olsson, and as I said, I know we got a speed, they just gotta stay focused and doesn't make any mistakes really, and he'll be a contender to win for sure. Nicely double-double out of the section. Quite tricky if you land wrong. So Fjellberg coming out for the finish. Looks like Birkin and Victor Nykott is going down. But only Nykott going off the bike. So our top three is Jonathan Olsson, there's Fjellberg and Matt Birkin, which is, I'd say, the three strongest guy in this field. I could put Yannick Mulder there as well, momentarily, but it really depends on his race. Soto with Victor Nykott and Kevin Leelong. Looks like Birkin went down. Got going again pretty quickly. Clement Lana loves to catch up a little bit. Kevin Leelong has once again made his way up a little bit in the field. Nicely going over tabletop, staying to the inside and just going wide open. So Jonathan also actually extending the lead with a few seconds, and there's about 7 to 8 minutes to go before the one lap sign comes out. Dennis Fjellberg still maintaining second place. Matt Birkin still maintaining third. Lapper getting out of the way. Real good. Brandon Enink has dropped back to 21st. That was weird. So Enink not having the race of his life. Jeremy Seabolt. Rage quit probably. So Jonathan Olsson is still maintaining first place before Fjellberg. Feels like Matt Birkin is slowly but steadily catching up. We have a battle here between Clement Lana and Kevin Leelong. Lana currently holding third place, almost going into the SpongeBob's, and they both go down. So that was strange, allowing Victor Nykott to pass. So that was really weird. So Clement Lana and Kevin Leelong getting together, and both of them going different directions, one off the side of the jump. So it was really weird. And I see some guys say that they thought the race started the usual time, but you have to check the threads and everything to see that it does not. So, and there was a post about it in the EMF section as well, so you had a warning, and it was weird, I gotta say. So Clement Lana crashing. allowing Kevin Leland to go by. Victor Nyquist just pulling away from these guys. So Anthony Bernard battling it out with Yannick Müller for, I believe that's 6th. Let's go on board with Yannick here and see, lap 12. So there's about 4.5 minutes to go before it's a one lap sign comes out. Both going to the inside, I believe they're going split lanes here. I don't really think it matters which line you take. I think they're pretty much as quick, just whichever you feel more comfortable with. Tripling down nicely, both to the inside. And if you want to, you can actually land in the signal on the inside, but I don't know if it's actually quicker. I just think it adds more risk to not really that much reward. But I'm sure it would be good for a hot lap or something. So here it's just pretty much the opening wide open and try to get over the triple. But this triple is not too bad, doesn't really happen anything if you case it, so that's kind of a relief. You also have to be careful at this point to not jump too far either way, since with added new... Oh, that was just so terrible from Sambal. As I said, you have to be careful now with the new updated collision, since it's actually added frame, so the frame underneath the motorbike can actually hit the dirt, and that will create some extra stopping. So Müller allows to pass for 6th place. And it was Anthony Bernard, Yannick passed. Next up is Eduardo Simas for 8th place, Sebastian Jost and Clement Lana. So Clement Lana really dropping far back. Something must have happened. Did not expect Clement Lana to drop this far back. So I'm sure he caught up with a lap or something. There he's made his own mistake. So Mattias Lidman, Anders Goransson, Enzo Bottinelli, Chase Dunnemont, Van Seeberg, Bronson Gasparian, Josh Bradshaw and Durano Kluivets for top 20. Looks like Dennis Filbert just got around Jonathan Olsson. Jonathan Olsson staying right on the tail, but going to be interesting to see here if there's anyone wants to make a move or something. I think Dennis has it at this point. He's usually so consistent. So unless he crashes, I think he has it pretty much. But I mean, as you can see, Lappers, and there comes Jonathan also. Really close by now. But overall, I think Lappers is doing a pretty good job of staying out of the way. Like, obviously not the best, but pretty decent job. It actually looks like Jonathan Olsson is charging really hard right now, so I think he kind of got a smell of victory once he got so close to Fjellberg, so he wanna try to step up the game. Challenge Fjellberg here on the last lap. Oh, Olsson make a slight mistake, sliding a little bit, as well as Stannis makes a mistake. So they're both going downhill at the same time. Nobody wants to crash at this point, because then it's pretty much over if the other guy just can stay on the wheels. Both clearing the triple. One going to the inside, one going to the outside. Looking pretty even. Dennis Fjellberg still jumping that far on the jump before there. It could be so sketchy. And it looks like we have a battle shaping up here for the last lap. Fjellberg going to the inside, carrying a slightly bit more momentum. We have a lapped rider in the way, just also managing to avoid him as well as his SpongeBob, so great. Dennis Fjellberg managing to go around on the other side as well. Fjellberg's tucks, oh, that was really cool. So Fjellberg makes a mistake, Jonas Allison just goes straight into him and makes a front flip. That was really fun from a battling perspective, so nice to see that nobody crashed. We have the number 11 here, a lapper. And if he ruins the race, I'm going to be so pissed. I don't think he will. So this is the last lap here. So whoever comes around as leader of this lap will win. Unless there is some penalty, but I don't think it will be. So we had somebody cheering on Olson here. Edward Mora. So it's a really good battle, I gotta say. But it actually looks like this Fjellberg is pulling away slightly as he makes another mistake. So Fjellberg, I guess he's pretty not nervous, but feeling pressure or something at this point. That was kind of a douche move, but he's been taking that line all day, so I guess it's kind of okay. Should I expect him to take this line as well? That was actually Matt Birkin catching up to these guys. I haven't realized, but Matt Birkin is really close. So Matt Birkin really have a shot at the win here if these two crashes. So that was really nice to see. Matt Birkin have a great ride. Fjellberg actually doing the scrub down. Must say he had a pretty brave mind if he scrubs on the last lap. And the lapper number 11 was Enzo Butignidi. So Fjellberg has it at this point unless he crashes, but I'm pretty sure that he won't. That was a big scrub. So Fjellberg taking the win in front of Jonathan Olsson and Matt Birkin. So that was really good racing. Kevin Lilong seems to be taking 4th in front of Victor Nycott. And Dennis Fjellberg, I don't think anyone has a fast lap time, but at a 1:48, so that's insanely fast. Jonathan Olsson with a 1:52, so Dennis Fjellberg clearly being the fastest one there in that group. But Jonathan Olsson staying consistent and getting the second place at the moment. Victor Nycott finishing 5th. Jack Mulder worked his way up to 6th in front of Anthony Bernard. Eduardo Simas seems to be 8th. Brock Pappy probably going to finish 9th. Clement Lana making it at least to the top 10, staying there. Quentin de la Rule, 11th, Sebastian Jost, 12th, Matthias Liedman, 13th, Enzo Butignidi, Chase Dunmont, Lance Gunners, and Ben Seaborg, Bronson Gasparian, Josh Bradshaw, and Duran of Plevot, running up the top 20. So that's pretty much it. I have Sebastian Jost about to finish. We have Matthias Liedman. And these are the guys left inside the top 20. So a lot of great racing here. Cuts should zoom in so we can see if Fjellberg maintains his lead and Matthias Liedman just crashing out. Nice cameraman in the picture. So Liedman is going to take 13th, and Jonathan Olsson got penalized by 2 seconds himself, so he almost lost that second place. So great racing, congratulations to Dennis, Jonathan and Matt Birkin for being on the podium. And let's wait for 450 Moto 1 to start.